Today, it's a bow tie on steroids as we twin turbo a new Camaro to 600 horsepower.
From day one, Ford and Chevy fans have been at each other's throats on the street and at the strip. And that war for bragging rights never cools down. And nobody knows that better than a top blue oval warrior named John URIST. John designs, builds, and races Mustangs professionally and has just captured another winning season driving his Hellion-powered Fox Body Mustang to his ninth NMCA World Championship. And you guys who watch our show have seen him strap on big Chevy whipping turbo power to late model Mustangs with his trick new Coyote twin turbo kit. So we were surprised, really surprised, when he brought us a new turbo system to boost stock late model Camaros. Finally, the LS crowd is getting access to Hellion power.
This Camaro is actually a mirrored image of Don Walsh Jr.'s 5-second twin turbo Pro Mod that sports a 521-inch BAE Hemi with twin 88mm precision Pro Mod turbos.
Not only does this type of system set records at the track, it's now available for the street in a bolt-on package. The heart of the system are twin 62mm precision ball-bearing ProMod style turbos with a stainless housing. Now they also have a modern V-band inlet technology that allows for faster spooling and increased power potential. Hellion uses only the highest quality components in their systems, like K&N filters, Deechworks injectors, MSD wires, and Turbosmart wastegates and blow-off valves with the Hellion name right on top.
The Camaro has needed some horsepower for a long time, and its time has come. With the success we've had over the years with all of our systems, all of those components are used in this new Camaro SS kit. Everything's been tested, everything's been proven. Racetrack, street-driven, dyno-proven, everything is meant for the long haul.
With so many advantages, why would you not want to add a set of twin turbos to your ride? Now, from this point on, you're about to see the entire install of this system on that Camaro. Now, the end result is going to make bolt-on blowers sneeze with embarrassment as we crack the 600 horsepower mark back on the chassis dyno with that bone-stock LS3.
With a wide-open view of the engine bay, John's friend Hoyt Dutton is back to assist with another install. He helped make over 950 horsepower in the Boss 302 Coyote Mustang we did last season, so he had to come back. The teardown starts by removing the stock airbox assembly, including the tube to the throttle body. And right behind it goes the engine cover. Now remove the ECU and its bracket from the passenger subframe rail. The power wire from the power distribution module needs to be unbolted, along with the PDM, which lays off to the side for now. The ground strap from the frame to the cylinder head comes off, along with the front wheels, so we can access the passenger inner fender well and remove it.
The only modification needed to the actual car is removing the PDM bracket, which makes room for the turbo. To do this, Hellion supplies a spot weld cutter in the kit to make this step as easy as snapping your fingers. The dipstick needs to be removed, along with the plug wires and the spark plugs. Now we can unbolt the exhaust from the manifold's collector. And both manifolds come out and will not be reused. With the teardown pretty much complete, we can go ahead and wrap several lines and hoses with this heat shield to protect it. Now that's due to the larger headers and where the turbos are actually going to be placed. Now this stuff is a must for added protection, and we'll go ahead and knock most of it out during this break.
With the teardown complete, let the install begin.
Wait, you have those cutters I can borrow real quick?
We're back with the Hellion Power Systems crew installing a twin turbo system on this new 2014 Camaro SS. So far, we completed the teardown and just wrapped several lines and hoses with heat shielding.
I'm pretty excited. We're gonna make some power today.
And we're still a ways away from that. Now, using a U-bracket from the kit, we can pull the AC line away from the engine and secure it. The fuel injectors need to be swapped now. We're removing the factory 42-pound-an-hour units and installing 65-pound-an-hour ones that will support up to 650 rear-wheel horsepower. With that out of the way, we need to relocate the coil brackets using more pieces from the kit. Now they need to be raised to make room for the downpipes.
Unbolting this ground from the head will allow us to relocate the passenger side wiring harness above the valve cover. The stock fuel line needs a few quick bends to reposition it over the rear of the intake manifold. It gets wrapped with heat shield before being reattached to the fuel rail. For even more header clearance, we need to replace the factory steel fuel vent hose with a rubber one from the kit. The turbos are lubricated with oil from the engine. On LS blocks, there's an oil galley plug that's on the lower front driver side that we'll use to pressurize the turbos with engine oil. To access it, we'll need to remove the serpentine, which allows us to unbolt the alternator and lean it forward. Now the plug can be removed, and the supplied washer and bushing can be tightened. Using some pipe sealant, a -4 AN to 1/8 inch pipe can be screwed into it, and the braided steel oil feed line attaches to it and is routed to the front of the engine. At this point, the alternator can go back on along with the belt. On the front frame support, a fender clip is installed in the factory hole, which gives the ECU relocation bracket a place to anchor to. The other fastener uses a factory captured nut in the frame support. Now the ECU and its retaining bracket can attach to it.
The oil lubricating the turbos has to return to the oil pan. So with these spots marked, we can make the holes using the supplied roto bit. Now go slow, and right before it makes its way through, slow down even more so the plug is captured in the bit. With heavy grease on the 3/8 tap from the kit, we can make threads in the pan for the fittings. The grease will catch the shavings and keep them from falling in. A 3/8 to -10 straight fitting prepped with pipe sealant can thread into its new home. Now the same step happens on the other side, so each turbo has a drain. Fabbed from scratch, URIST and his guys do all the design work for the turbo piping and the headers in-house. Now these are an up and forward design that start out with a 3/8 thick flange that dump into 1¾ inch primaries. Now this small pipe way up front with the V-band houses the wastegate, and this is where the turbo mounts. The coating is Jet Hot's Extreme 1300 that resists corrosion and can withstand 1300 degree temperatures. It bolts up using the factory steel gasket and original hardware. Now the dipstick can go back in its original place, and the ABS module receives heat protection as well by using a heat shield from the kit. A longer ground strap is supplied to clear the header. Now it's wrapped in more heat protection and goes from the frame to the head. Before the driver's side header can go on, the downpipe needs to be put in position. We'll secure it with a zip tie for now. This header is a mirrored image of the other side and goes on with factory hardware.
The factory spark plugs are reused, but the gap has to be tightened up to 30 thousandths to keep the flame from blowing out due to the additional cylinder pressure from the turbos. A custom length MSD wire set is also supplied because of the relocated coil packs. And with that, we're halfway there.
Up next, the main components of the system to get ready for the main event.
We're back and the twin turbo install continues. Other than the fire up, this is the most exciting part of the system, mounting the boost producers. They're secured to the header using a V-band clamp and will be left loose for now on both sides. The downpipe we dropped in earlier can be attached to the turbo's exhaust now using another V-band clamp, followed by the wastegate's dump pipe, which directs the relieved exhaust pressure into the exhaust. Now the wastegates can be mounted, which controls how much boost the system will make. They're also secured with V-bands, which compress both flanges together to cause a leak-proof seal. The drain line from the turbo can attach to the previously installed fitting on the pan. And up top, the -4 feed lines split off of a T and can attach to the fittings on the top of the turbo housing. To cool the compressed air from the turbos is a bar and plate style intercooler. Now this one has two inlets down here, one for each turbo, and a single outlet that feeds the cooler compressed air to the intake manifold. Now this thing will support every bit of power that that turbo system can produce, which is about 1200. To get it in, the front fascia must be removed, along with two plastic panels to make room for the cold side piping.
We also need to pull out the windshield washer reservoir. This one is not reused. Using three supplied brackets, we can mount the cooler to the core support. Then install the mass air flow sensor from the factory airbox into the intercooler and plug the supplied extension harness into it. Now we can plumb the cold side, which starts with silicone couplers at the turbos. On the driver's side, the first pipe, which houses the blow-off valve, can drop in. Using two more couplers, the final pipe can make the connection to the intercooler and get tightened in place. The same goes for the passenger side.
Now the blow-off valves can be installed. As the throttle is closed, the boost pressure has to be released into the atmosphere so the turbo is not damaged by the surge of boost still in the system. Now the final run of piping. From the intercooler through the fender well, and up to the throttle body, where the last coupler is installed to seal it all up. Vacuum lines are now ran to the wastegates and the blow-off valves, which gives them the signal to open and close. Now, K&N filters will protect the turbos from the outside elements, and this line goes to the crankcase vent. The engine cover is a must to reuse to hide all the factory harnesses. After a quick trim on both sides, new heat shields can be attached, which makes the finished look hard to take your eyes off of.
Now the factory exhaust can be removed and replaced with a better flowing and much better sounding Magnaflow 3-inch system that's constructed of stainless steel. It tucks super tight to the bottom of the car for ground clearance, and the mufflers are a stainless design with polished tips.
Cool.
Lowered back down, the Camaro gets its face back to restore that aggressive muscle car look. The wheels and tires go back on now.
Injectors are in, no leaking. Looks good to me. How's it look over there?
One more check to make sure everything is complete.
I think we're in good shape. All this stuff is nice and tight.
From the lift to the rollers, the quest starts to find 600 plus horsepower.
All right, clear prop, are you ready? And finally, the moment we all look forward to when finishing up an install like this, the fire up.
All right.
This is the time we look everything over and make sure there are no leaks and everything is functioning as it should.
Johnny boy, I think you did it again.
Thank you very much.
This looks awesome. Looks awesome. Really nice and clean install.
Now to the dyno for the tuning session.
Nicotine 6 and 7 to start with.
Okay. There's a new face in the shop.
Right.
Ed Hutchings, who owns HiTech Tuning, is here to perform his expert tuning ability on this twin-turbo Camaro using an interface most of you are familiar with, HP Tuner's VCM Suite.
Typically, I'll just work from the right to the left along the toolbar. I'll start with the fan temps, lower those, move on to the transmission, eliminate the skip shift for a 6-speed, move on to the engine diag. I tune for a lot of professional shops all across the country. I have several shops internationally that I tune for, in Europe, Asia. As long as someone has HP tuners on the other end of the line, I can tune it through the internet.
The first thing Ed is doing is turning the fans on earlier so the engine runs cooler. It will allow full fan speed at 205 degrees. Now the transmission skip shift feature is disabled. The catalyst overtemp condition can be changed now by adjusting maximum enrichment. It's adjusting wide open throttle fueling so a super rich condition does not occur. The PE delay is lowered to less than idle speed so there is no delay. EQ ratio from 0 to 1250 RPM. This doesn't matter. In the timing table, a total of 7 degrees is removed under wide open throttle conditions.
One of the key features to the HP Tuner suite is the ability to open a second tune in a compare feature. This is the original tune. This is your compare tune. This is the difference between the two. Click back here and copy and paste known good data from one tune into another.
With Ed's changes made, he can load them into the Camaro's ECM through the VCM suite, which gives you the status of the file as it loads. The only thing left is to start the dyno session.
The first pull is from 2,000 to 4,800, so Ed can look at the data log,
the timing table,
and make sure all the parameters are safe.
Good. We'll take some fuel out of it.
It's really rich right now, so he'll pull some fuel out of it at wide open throttle. And another run from 2,000 to 5,000 RPM, where it made 513 horsepower and 564 foot-pounds of torque. Now another change in the mass air table, since it's still on the rich side. Fueling changes are made by telling the computer the mass airflow sensor is flowing less or more air. So basically, when fueling is changed, it's done by recalibrating the mass air sensor. Now another pull, but stepping it up to 6,000. 567 horsepower, 594 foot-pounds of torque. Now at this point, if we're going to creep past that 600 horse number, a spring change is in the works. Going from a 7 to 10 pound spring will definitely get us there. Now that was our first full pull from 2 to 6,700 RPM. It made 539 horsepower, 560 foot-pounds.
Just flickered for a second.
Now the knock sensors did their job by sensing detonation, which removed timing, causing that loss in power. So Ed's making a few changes to the timing so it doesn't happen again. During this run, we should see around 9 pounds of boost, and if all goes as planned, the 600 horse mark will get cracked. And it does, 603 with 600 foot-pounds.
We want to add some power to these cars for a long time. I think we just did.
Yeah, no joke. Very good power too. That's crazy. 65 pound injectors, stock cats.
Stock fuel pump.
That's just unreal. That's what it's all about.
Looks good on the dyno. I'm gonna go drive it.
That's why you got all the championships and all that good stuff going on. Yeah, look at that smile.
It's all right.
Rub it in.
We can build a motor and turn it up now, all with the same kit.
But this one's leaving with over 600 horsepower and emissions legal.
Increased horsepower requires increased fuel supply, and Accel's 500 thruster series in-tank pumps for EFI deliver the goods by supporting up to 900 horsepower while still using the stock fuel lines. Its turbine design is E85 compatible, and it's a direct fit in most applications, and it also comes with a handy installation kit. It's also great for EFI conversions and has a flow rate of 500 pounds per hour at 43.5 PSI. Best of all, it's available at your local performance center for under 200 bucks.
If you're planning one of the most popular V8 swaps in history into an older vehicle, Holley Performance has the answers to the headaches created by LS accessory drives. Now, whether you're working with an F-body, a Corvette, or a truck-style water pump offset, Holley's universal brackets will work with any one of them as long as you have the correct installation kit. Now, all the pulleys and accessories are supplied by OEM suppliers, so no corners were cut with quality. Now, you can pick yours up anywhere Holley products are sold for just under $1,200, plus the cost of the installation kit. But don't let that hold you back. This is still the cheapest accessory drive on the market.
If you have a 98 to 99 5.7 liter Camaro or Firebird and want better breathing, Magnaflow has your setup with these titanium ceramic coated beauties. The stainless 1 3/4 inch primaries are a tuned length, and they're made from a 16 gauge CNC mandrel bent tubing, and they'll bolt right up where your stock exhaust manifolds were. The kit comes with everything you need for a smooth install, and all it takes is a few simple hand tools and a few hours of your time to get the job done. It's an easy way to increase your car's HP, and they're available from your favorite automotive parts supplier. Well, that's it for engine power. We'll see you next time.